Greetings of the day, students. I, Kiran Nagde, Assistant Professor, Department of Advanced Management Studies, GS College of Commerce, Vardha. Today, we are going to talk about the Marketing Specialization Paper Number 3, which is Integrated Marketing Communication. In earlier lecture, we have discussed and we have seen and discussed the concept of brand communication. In today's lecture, we are going to talk about how brand communication works. As we can already know that the brand communication begins with communication, and the most basic what can be derived from brand communication, the basic definition will be the brand communication is a message to the customer about your brand. Okay, so what does brand communication does? So it gets an attention and provide information, sometimes even entertainment to the customer. So it is a purposeful in message which seeks to create some kind of response. That response will be in form of any inquiry or sale or visit to a website or a test drive. Before jumping to the brand communication model, I would like to discuss here one mass communication model, that is SMCR model. S stand for source, M stand for message, C stand for channel, and R stand for receiver model. This model is given in the earlier of 1940 by the Shannon and the Beaver. What they have said in this mass communication model is the communication process begins with first a source, second a sender who encodes this message or the source and puts it in a words or a picture. Then there will be one message, third point. The message is presented through four, that is channel of communication, such as newspaper, radio, television, etc. Then the message is decoded or interpreted by the receiver, that is the sixth element. And then who is the receiver is who? The receiver is who? Is a reader or viewer or the listener. The last step is seventh, that is feedback, and which is obtained by monitoring the responses of the receiver to the message. The entire process is complicated by the noise. There will be two classification of noise, external noise and internal noise. So noise is what? Noises are the things that interrupt the sending and receiving of a message, such as a bad connection of words with unclear meaning. Now we have to translate this SMCR model into brand communication, where the source typically is the marketer. Then next you have is this marketer will assisted by its agency, that is a message. And then next we have who encodes the information into various types of marketing communication. So what they are saying is in brand communication model, the source typically is the marketer assisted by its agency who encodes the information into various types of marketing communication that we can see from diagram. That source, message, media mix. Next is the receiver of your information. Next, the message can be an advertisement or other any marketing communication, such as a press release or any store banner or any brochure or video or any web page. Okay, so marketer and its agency determines the goals and objective for the message in terms of effects they want from that particular message. Now when they decide the goals and objective, there has to be some mechanism where you can get a feedback or responses responses from the receiver or the customer. Okay, so they will choose some media channel which are the vehicles that will deliver your message to the receiver. Then there will be another two factors, which are the first one we have is noise, which are the external noise. So external noise are those things which hinders the consumer reception of the message, includes technical or the socio-economic trends that affect the reception of the message. For example, public opinion. If suppose eating fast, there are some health concerns to your friends about eating fast food, so that will affect your decision to eat the fast food only. So that is external noise. Next you have is internal noise. So in internal noise includes personal factors that affect the reception of an advertisement, such as the receiver's needs and the wants, or the language skills, or the purchase history, or the information processing ability and all those and another personal factors also. Suppose you have purchased one product and you didn't get the expected result from that product. The next thing will be, if you are going to purchase the another product, you are not going to purchase the same product which didn't meet your needs, right? And that is what they are saying, that internal noise affected the message receiver, affected the consumer reception of the message. Next, the last part of this brand communication model is feedback. So feedback is the reaction, the which reaction of the audience of a particular message. Okay, so this is a brand communication model. It starts from the source message, then we have message, media mix, then the last part of it will be the receiver, where we are going to check consumer reception of message and the responses. Now this lecture will be concluded as an important thing to remember, that the communication process is not a foolproof or even dependable process. Rather, it's very complicated to understand the advertising communication process, right? But if the communication process fails to work and the consumer does not receive the message as intended by the advertiser, then the communication effort will be ineffective. And that is why the significance of brand communication is very high in case of integrated marketing communication. In next lecture, we are going to talk about various models of brand communication. Until then, stay tuned and please subscribe to the channel of GS College of Commerce eLearning. Thank you.